we've always kind of had this dream to live in a tiny home or a shipping container or an earth ship or something along those lines. And we originally thought that we needed to save up a bunch of money, buy land, and then buy this really expensive tiny home and make it livable. And we just thought that was such a far stretch for us and that it would never happen. And so Francois actually stumbled upon the YouTube community of van life, and that's when we kind of realized maybe we could do this in the meantime. Like, you, it's not a huge investment. It's a little bit, but not as much as land. And so that's kind of what sparked the interest. And this kind of facilitates everything we like as well. We love being outdoors. We love traveling. And our home will always be with us.
It's not just you buy a camper van and you go for it. There are some steps to it. So we decided to, first off, start by minimalizing everything. And we found ourselves in the bedroom pulling everything out one by one. And we were sitting in the middle of the room with everything everywhere. And we're like, oh my God, like, I can't do this.
We had a schedule that we were following of things to get rid of every day. But we would find ourselves getting rid of loads of stuff each day. And so it was a little bit overwhelming at how much we had accumulated in such a small apartment. It took months of practicing, really, and
yeah.
I've grown from it, and there's still a few things I'm having a hard time letting go of. My record player, that's one of the big ones.
Yeah.
But for the most part, once you start getting rid of things, it becomes easier after that. Mm-hmm. By the end, we had all of our stuff in boxes and a mattress on the floor. We don't want to give people the wrong impression either. Like, we're not total minimalists yet. We still have not reached that point, I don't think. It's still a work in progress, and I think it always will be.
That stuff, once we started the minimalist approach, immediately after starting, you feel this weight come off your shoulders, and you feel this, like, you can breathe, and you're like, wow. You know, so there's immediate reward, for us at least, for downsizing. This is Molly the van, and it's a 1998 Chevy Express van converted by StarCraft. I decided to pull the seats out. I built a bed and a kitchenette area for under $100, and we added a Mr. Buddy heater. We also have storage up top, at the front, at the back. Most of the storage is underneath in bins. As a bathroom, I use a 5-gallon pail. It's called the Lugaloo from Canadian Tire. And yeah, it's pretty simple. Just poop in a pail, even. I got a shovel right here, you know?
In case.
And it's brand new, hasn't been used yet. But this shovel can dig a hole, and you can poop in a hole or pee in a hole, whatever you desire. It's pretty simple, just like camping, right?
The roof is actually tall enough for the both of us to stand up in. The bed is actually just temporarily set up for one person. But we are thinking we're probably going to have to turn the bed this way to be able to accommodate both of us. So this is just a temporary setup while he goes and experiences it and figures out what's bad and what needs work before I move into it. So in order to start to make this happen, Francois actually quit his job quite recently, 2 weeks ago. He was working as a barista, and he's gonna start the journey and test it out and see how it goes. And I unfortunately can't quit my job. I've committed to a contract, so I'm gonna stick around for the next few months until my job ends in June. And then I'm going to join in, and we're gonna start to build it and head off together.
The plan is essentially to be semi-retired by the age of 30. We want to do 6 months of work and then 6 months off of work. That way it's more of a better balance. And obviously that's our goal, so we don't know how it's going to end up.
And to do that too, we don't really know which jobs we're going to do. We don't know if we might find a city and decide to work, you know, a part-time job there for a few months and then go on the road again. And I think we're just gonna kind of play it by ear.
what I'm most excited about is just meeting the people. I want to meet more like-minded people. I want to hear their stories, share their stories.
I'm most excited for the lifestyle change and the challenges that are going to come our way. So it's going to be exciting to live at our own pace and to take the time to enjoy things. Mm-hmm.